Now, you brought something I have to say it. Some maybe will think that this is kind of speculation, but this is pretty close to reality speculation. Guys, like I stated, surgery is a trauma, and we have to consider it. Doesn't matter how good, in her case, fusion nails, this is a blessing, and that they were capable to reduce the swelling within the spinal cord and to fuse it, you know, that it will be not tear and will not traumatize the spinal cord significant. Yeah, no matter how good it is, it's significant trauma. Living patients with post-surgical side effects, fascial tension with the muscles. This is where all start. Well, right now we're talking on body and mind, but physically, this is where it all starts. And mentally too, this is a car accident and surgery, it's pretty significant emotional trauma. Physical and emotional trauma is a horrible combination. Horrible combination.
Well, the when they do surgery, surgery on bone, you have to cause trauma to all the soft tissues.
Okay. Of course you're coming. That's what I mean.
So that is what me, and that is what so many of my patients, when they come to me after having lower lumbar, that this is just happens to be a very popular one, surgery, they come to me, and the sooner they come to me, the quicker that I can release it. But the very first thing that I notice is that all of the muscles and all of the tissues that they had to cut through have now turned to adhesives. They're all adhering to each other, and the scar tissue,
you have to manage it.
And so why are they not feeling better? Well, because they've taken away one problem and replaced it with another
problem. And this is our duty to rehabilitate.
Right.
This is what I'm trying to say. Maybe some will consider this speculation, but my strong feeling, if I will get you immediately after surgery,
I agree 100%.
You will not end up with dystonia.
Absolutely.
This you will, you wouldn't. Again, and why? Because I will not allow. I will clean the brain neuromatrix with stimulating. This is the two types of pain in other clinical phenomena, such as scrump and all this, is one tissue injury. It's called like this. It's officially called tissue injury pains due to fracture surgery, and one brain generated pain in phenomena such as cramps. In your case, it's both lower motor centers and upper motor centers. Where is the nerve matrix?
When we first spoke, mm-hmm. you not knowing my entire condition and just from witnessing what you had done, we had talked about probably just lower motor sensory. After, you know, that is where after examining me and talking to me and getting the history where you were able to say, okay, it's both. It's not one or the other. It's both.
Absolutely.
And so both have to be addressed.
Your case is a classic, typical, by the way. Yeah, it's both. You have to address also neuromatrix to clean. Look, Holly. Look what happened. And I know a little bit your professional background before you became massage therapist, it was pretty stressful. And the mainly, right now, it's enough to focus on this tragic event when you got involved in this car accident. First moment before you probably lost conscious, it was significant attack of fear, probably. Oh, brain, remember this. Neuromatrix is the...
I remember it.
You see, but brain, you remember this consciously.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, but this anxiety.
I remember right up to the moment I went unconscious.
Absolutely. But all I just want to explain to you why I said we have classic, when I was listening careful mm-hmm. to you, we have classic combination of emotional trauma and physical trauma, brain generated phenomenon. And real tissue damages, pain. Look, the point is that what it starts from this trauma, physical and emotional, and it's a snowball. Besides, it's continued accumulation of tension with the muscles and fascia, little by little. Meantime, it's because surgery, it's because of fusion, this is because of this, and this, and this. And this is like a glass with water. You can drop a lot until last drop will be, and it will start spilling out. These symptoms of dystonia, these cramps and all.
It was when the glass of water got.
Absolutely, and I will tell you where, what, according what you said to me, I'm just analyzing all what you reported to me. Look, muscles and fascia, soft tissue, the threshold was very low already. It didn't cramp, probably sometime used to bother you, didn't cramp. Now, this is on peripheral level. On central, posterior horns of spinal cord, also threshold go down. Accordingly you see, you're accumulating tension, it's depriving blood supply, threshold of pain go down, little bit wind will probably, will get a high resting tone. It's all this is the process. When you're at a practice where hit it to the head, but you have to understand this lower threshold on the level of lower motor centers, it's also upper motor centers all involved. We have computer, we have supercomputer, hypothalamus and cortex there. All under control, all is good. The memories pains, memories phenomena, and anxiety, all is there. We sometimes people calling this unconscious, maybe this subconscious, maybe. But we know this. Professor Maslach, in his theory, he just put it, I knew always it was observation. All scholars, bigger doctors said, we cannot explain where and what, but body cells, its bookmarks, carry emotional memory. It's used to be called conversion syndrome. I don't know if I'm translating well. Some people can demonstrate stroke like this. And brain is good, and this is brain generated for some different reason. Somehow mind will close. And well, you explain and you do massage and you explain, suddenly, all symptoms go. If this would be trauma of brain due to stroke or whatever, it will not go. This is something organic changes. Yeah, it will not go so fast. Yeah. Now, all brain remember, the last drop that spill what phenomenon? This is this cramps. It was when you practice this combat. Stuff, whatever.
Kickboxing.
Punch. You see, it's already all preconditioned to blow up. Punch! Boom! And they all got in terrible spasm. And right now, uncontrollable, the lower motor centers start firing. This, in your case, is on level of lower motor center. Firing and firing to the point that it starts cramping and twisting you. Terrible. Now brain remember all. Now brain fueling this phenomenon. And this way I said sometime, thank God when you start moving, but sometime you little by little will have maybe repeated episodes, and this is related to this memory. It's already, I will explain right now on tissue injury what we did. It's already there, but we will clean up. This is why I'm incorporating in all of your treatments, I'm incorporating a lot of kneading to clean up this narrow matrix, to stimulate the narrow matrix capacity, this bad memory. If you remember, you're a very strong woman. I saw this from very moment, and I saw you suppressing emotions. I awakened it, and your body ready to release it, you suppress it. I said, hold it. Don't do this. We need to, in any case I would release it. Everyone, when we perform a full body massage for people, we're releasing, we're stimulating, and all this memory, this, forgive me, garbage, that poison, you can call mental poison, it's go away. And I always say, people sometimes crying on tables, and I ask them to cry out all this what you have.
That's very, very normal.
But you're surprised, but one time you listened to me, and this was great. And this was great. We will continue to clean this narrow mantra.
Well, I have a question
for
that. Mm-hmm. When the muscles, the fascia, when the soft tissues have a very low threshold to pain and to reaction, I know when I've started to clear that up. I can feel it. The patient allows me to get in there more. What are the signs? How do you know when the mental part of it is clearing up? Because that takes longer.
This individual case. Maybe the process of cleaning up, the memory take longer. It all depends how much garbage there. Forgive me, this poison. But look, how you know? When people reporting you sleeping better, I'm talking on stress management. Oh, let's talk on orthopedic massage that we have to incorporate. When people reporting feeling better, less pain, more capabilities, you, like I said, it's impossible only to address tissue injuries, pain,
mm-hmm.
and not to address it. If, let's say, this is only theoretically, it's impossible otherwise, because all these impulses that we're creating when we're performing a massage, reaching and stimulating upper centers, the same matrix within hypothalamus and cortex. This is the power, this is the greatest power of massage therapy. Give me one method that can put by hands, by soft tissue manipulation by hands, in traditionally this is massage, that will make this big difference. Now, the moment when you objectively, physically start moving less and reporting no cervical, this is the most important. And I said to you, if you remember, I have experience with these cases, I said to you, Holly, the moment when cervical dystonia symptoms will go, because focal can more often to repeat, you will see all this episode with you. We know we cleaned brain a little bit. Why? Because all in general got down. The frequency of this repeated practically with cervical spine now, with cervical region, no this twitting and twisting. This ongoing process go together. You cannot address successfully only, this will be wrong if I will stay and will do a little bit connective tissue massage, trigger point, and address only. Yeah, that's why the general rules in medical massage, in any massage therapy, I will make statement difference of medical massage and massage therapy. I would love to have this opportunity to talk. In any massage therapy, this is the rules, general. And medical massage should be in any procedure, being this for stress management, orthopedic, or the sports massage. 50% of time, we must spend on kneading. No matter what we're doing on kneading. And why kneading? Because this massively, when we do kneading, we're deforming mechanoreceptors within skin, responsible receptors, what we're calling mechanoreceptors, receptors responsible for touch, reporting touch, pressure. Yeah, we're releasing, and when we're deforming.
Physioelectricity, right?
Absolutely, impulse. Action potential is an impulse. Yeah. It's like you're turning on. Right now, you don't feel I'm touching you. I touch you, you feel. This is results of this electrical impulse running and brain knowing to interpret that I touched you. And if I will apply pressure, but when I'm massively doing, kneading, huge amount of this action potential, this is what stimulation is. It's moving. You know what, I probably in descriptions of this video will put some article also linked to the articles that explaining physiological effect.
Well, I will tell you that the more I study medical massage, the more I understand and appreciate stress reduction massage and how it is so important.
No, I'm sorry. Call this stress management, please.
Stress management.
For me. Stress reduction.
Well, again, isn't this all about changing the thought process?
Yeah, stress management. You see, we to reduce side effects of stress, I will agree. But I love, and this is how I was trained, medical stress management massage. And by the way, any massage therapy is medical massaging, especially stress management.
Exactly.
Include kneading.
And that's
but I will give the difference.
Stress management massage, as you said, is so critical to healing the body. And the medical, and that's why 50% of our medical massage needs to be stress management.
In any massage.
Correct.
Have to complete
but
kneading.
I originally, my thoughts were, was to leave the stress management massage and go to the segmental reflex massage and to work that. And you have to, I've come to realize that you have to incorporate it all in order to be successful.